Greetings. Does spirit mean prophet? The Word of God reveals the Comforter. Ahmed Deedat claims that Mohammed is the Comforter. Let's look at Deedat's scriptural foundation. His foundation is 1 John 4, verse 1. Let's see what Deedat has to say.
But we are told it's a spirit. Is Muhammad a spirit? I say yes. That's what your Bible says. You see, every time the word spirit is used in your Bible, I'm telling the Christian, it doesn't stand for the Holy Ghost. Because in the book of Revelation, the last book of the Bible, we are told that seven spirits of God went out into the world. I say, you believe in seven Holy Ghosts? He says, no, there's only one Holy Ghost. I said, you said seven spirits. I mean, it should be seven Holy Ghosts. No, spirit doesn't stand for Holy Ghost every time. Then in the same John, in the first epistle of John, chapter 5, verse 4, he says, beloved, believe not every spirit, but try the spirits whether they are of God, for many false prophets have gone out into the world. So false spirit is a false prophet is a false spirit, true prophet is a true spirit. St. John is using spirit for a prophet. Don't believe every spirit. Don't believe in every prophet.
1 John 4:1 says, beloved, believe not every spirit, but try the spirits, whether they are of God, because many false prophets are gone out into the world. And then he says, see, spirit is a prophet, prophet is a spirit, so blah, blah, blah. Deedat wrongly equates spirit to prophet. Why does Deedat need to do this? Jesus clearly states who the Comforter is. John 14:26 says the Holy Spirit is the Comforter. John 15:26 says the Spirit of Truth is the Comforter. Deedat does get one thing correct. The Greek word in Holy Ghost is pneuma. So Holy Ghost does mean Holy Spirit. The two terms are interchangeable. But equating spirit to prophet is simply bonkers. Let's look again at 1 John 4:1. Beloved, believe not every spirit, but try the spirits, whether they are of God, because many false prophets are gone out into the world. So let's ask one question here. Who does a prophet speak for? Think about it. Who does a prophet speak for? Does a prophet speak for himself? No, a prophet is a messenger. He speaks for another, for someone else. Is every messenger a prophet? Is a messenger for a king necessarily a prophet? No. Is a messenger for a man, any man, a prophet? No. What then makes a messenger a prophet? A messenger is a prophet when they speak for a spirit. So a prophet speaks for a spirit. A prophet is a man, a human being, and he speaks for a spirit. Let's look again at 1 John 4:1 with the new understanding that a prophet speaks for a spirit. Beloved, believe not every spirit, but try the spirits. Try them, test them, examine them, evaluate them, critique them, put them under scrutiny whether they are of God. Because many false prophets are gone out into the world. We test the spirit by examining the words the prophet for the spirit says. And what does a true prophet say? 1 John 4:3, and every spirit that confesses not that Jesus Christ is come in the flesh is not of God. And this is that spirit of Antichrist. But Mohammed said Jesus is the Christ. That's the claim Deedat makes. Just wait, there is so much more to it. You see, the term Christ means the Son of God. But Jesus held his peace, and the high priest answered and said unto him, I adjure you by the living God that you tell us whether you be or are the Christ, the Son of God. The high priest of Israel knew that the Christ, who was also called the Messiah, would be the Son of God. That's the high priest. Christ really means, and carries the implication, Son of God. Who is a liar but he that denies that Jesus is the Christ? He is Antichrist that denies the Father and the Son. So go back and look. The other verse, 1 John 4:3, says this is the Antichrist that denies Jesus is the Christ. Here it fleshes it out, and this actually is said before in 1 John 2:22. He is Antichrist that denies the Father and the Son. Whoso denies the Son, the same has not the Father. He that acknowledges the Son has the Father also. So he that denies Jesus is the Son of God is a false prophet, speaking for a false spirit, and he is a liar. He is of the Antichrist. Does spirit mean prophet? No, clearly it does not. Is Mohammed the Holy Spirit, the Comforter? No, he is not. May the Spirit of God open your eyes to the light, your ears to the truth, and your heart to his Son, the Lord Jesus Christ. Amen.